In this video, I will show you how to master inpainting with ComfyUI, including creating and modifying objects in your images with ease. We will dive into the superior differential diffusion inpainting method that outperforms traditional inpainting techniques. From setting up your inpainting workflow to advanced masking and error correction, we will cover it all. Stay tuned until the end to take your ComfyUI skills to the next level. With that said, let's get started. First, you will need the Essentials and Impact Pack nodes, which we will be using in this video. You can find links to these in the description below. You can also download the ComfyUI Manager, which will install the nodes faster than installing them manually. So I recommend first downloading it if you don't already have it. For all of my Patreon supporters, you can download my updated workflow and use the missing nodes feature to download the nodes. Once you have downloaded everything, I will show you how to set up your inpainting workflow. First, we need the basic nodes. Just create and connect them as I am doing now and follow my steps. I also want to point out that from now on, I will only focus on the nodes that are new to you in my ComfyUI video series. If you don't understand what the basic nodes are and how they work, it's best to watch my previous videos. So the first node that's important for inpainting is the Gaussian Blur Mask node, which will blur your mask and help us create better transitions between the original image and our inpainted image. I'm also going to create a mask preview so we can see a preview of our mask. You don't have to create this, but you can if you want to. Then we need the Inpaint Model Conditioning node, which acts as a link to the K-sampler. And then, of course, we need Differential Diffusion, which is where all the magic happens, allowing us to do this new and improved inpainting method. Then you connect the rest of the base nodes. Oh, and don't forget to connect the VAE to the load checkpoint. I forgot to do that at the beginning and corrected it later. Once you've done all that, you are done and ready to mask. To demonstrate masking and inpainting, I am going to work with this image. Let's start with the SAM detector. You can use this tool to mask specific areas, which is very convenient, as it eliminates the need for manual editing with the mask editor. Simply left-click on the part of the image you want to mask. For example, I want to change the color of the dress, so I will mask the dress. Then click Detect, and the dress will be automatically masked. Make sure the confidence level is set high so that only the dress is selected. A higher confidence value means the recognition is more likely to be accurate. A lower value could, for example, result in the whole person being selected. Then click Save to Node, and the mask is saved. Another tool you can use to create masks is the mask editor. I use it, for example, to correct any errors in the mask made by the SAM detector. The only thing you need to know about the mask editor is that you can adjust the radius of your selection function for the mask using thickness. I have explained everything in detail in my ComfyUI document to keep you informed. There you will also find other information about nodes, models, and much more. The document is available for free on my Patreon and Discord. Once the mask is complete, you just need to click Save Nodes. Now that we have completed the masking step, I will show you how to change the color of objects. But first we need to make a few adjustments. First and foremost, I recommend setting both values in Gaussian Blur to 50. Next, copy the prompt you used to create the image and modify it to change the color of the dress or object you want to change the color of. Of course, you will also need to select the same model used to generate the image and transfer the same settings to K-sampler. It's worth noting that with this inpainting method, you don't necessarily need a specially trained inpainting model. You can use the same model that you used to create the image. As for the prompt, it's good to know that you don't have to stick to your original prompt. You can write something completely different or just focus on the object that needs to be changed. You can do a lot of experimenting to see what works best for your desired output. The same goes for the K-sampler settings. You can also play around with the values. Afterward, all you need to do is generate the image, and as you can see, the dress has now been changed to blue. You can get very creative here and do a lot of cool things with inpainting. Let me show you another example where I changed the dress to black. You can change your object or item to many different colors, but sometimes it might not work right away. You may need to tweak the CFG, denoise, and prompt to get the result you want. Therefore, I would like to emphasize, play with the K-sampler settings and the prompt. This will help you learn how these settings affect your image. Now let me demonstrate this with hair. As you can see, I have taken the woman in the black dress, and now I want to change her hair to black as well. I have adapted the mask to her hair, and the prompt now includes black hair. When generating, you may notice that it doesn't work correctly the first and second time, so I increased the CFG to give the prompt more influence on the result, and as you can see, it worked right away. I will also show you how to correct errors, such as not all hair being placed correctly. But first, here's another example with blue hair. If you have any questions about ComfyUI, feel free to ask them in the comments or better yet on Discord, where I can help you more effectively. Now I will show you how to fix inpainting errors. You can do this, for example, by masking the error areas, like in my case where the hair seems to be floating in the air. Then I simply regenerate the image and the errors are gone. I could reposition the hair in those areas, but I will leave it as it is. Next, I am going to show you how to inpaint objects. I am going to demonstrate this using my workflow, which is provided to all my Patreon supporters. Of course, you don't need this and can continue to use your own workflow, but for those who support my work on Patreon, I am now making this workflow available to them as a special thank you. I will demonstrate this topic by inpainting sunglasses on the woman's face. First, I draw a mask and add sunglasses to my prompt, then I apply my settings. As you can see, it doesn't work right away after the first generation, but after generating and changing the CFG several times, I finally get the right result. Always experiment with the values and learn. Don't forget that. Afterward, I upscale the image, and as you can see, we achieve a good result. Now that you have understood how it works, let's move on to changing the background. It's nothing special, you already know the basics, but I will demonstrate it anyway. To change the background, you simply need to mask it and specify in the prompt how you want it to look, for example, white wall. Then just generate the image, and as you can see, the background is now white. Even if there is an error, you already know how to fix it. And just like that, we are done with the topic of inpainting. If you have video suggestions, please write them in the comments. And don't forget to check out my ComfyUI video series if you haven't already. See you in the next video.